We have contact.
Huh. Contact indeed.
Welcome to the Ministry of Hygiene's gaming channel. I'm your host, the Minister of Hygiene. Let me go ahead and just get the girlish squeal out of the way. Yay! Because we're going to be playing Fallout 4. The latest game in one of my favorite gaming series of all time. And this is going to be my series Down of Fallout 4 in Boston. Ha ha ha, play on words. Enough with the rambling, let's get to gaming. I hope you enjoy. Okay, now okay. There we go. Checking out some settings. Wasted. And you can map it too. That's cool. But I'm sticking with it. Display. Make sure the subtitles are on. Good. And audio. Now, I need to make sure radio's off so I don't get a copyright strike. I'll go ahead and turn music off too. And, let's get the master volume up there. You don't really need to hear footsteps, do ya? There we go. And, let's do this. This is so cool. And, this is a pretty blank load screen. I was expecting more. I'd say I was expecting better from Bethesda. Much, much better. Kind of boring, actually. Not anything to look at but this. Oh, there! Something's happening. Okay, we get the intro. What are they gonna do? What's the intro gonna be? Fallout 4. So far, my favorite is actually Fallout 2's intro, where it's like a happy-go-lucky, let's get outside the vault video, and they get outside, they get gunned down.
War never changes.
Hey, that's not the guy who normally says that. What the hell?
In the year 1945.
What?
My great-great-grandfather.
Why are we going to 1945?
In the army. Wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife.
What?
And the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima.
Yeah, this is
Nagasaki.
Oh, pretty big. You know, it's pretty known history.
Instead, something miraculous happened.
Miraculous, huh?
We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once
pretty close.
Of science fiction. Domestic robots. Fusion-powered cars.
I'm pretty sure it probably need to be fission-powered cars, but...
But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource.
But if you've been using nuclear power to run everything, why are you short on... oil and other resources. I mean,
it is now the year 2077.
That doesn't make sense to me.
Stand on the brink of total war.
I mean, if you stop using oil for most things it's used for, why would you have a shortage of it?
For my infant son.
And it sounded like they stopped doing it a long time ago too. Yeah, less creaky chair. Oh.
It's that war
War never changes. Yeah. It's just... You just can't say it the same, my friend. You can't say it the same. Oh. Bit of a disappointment. Okay, cool.
War never changes.
You're gonna oh, no. Why the fuck would you just say that in a mirror out of nowhere? That makes no goddamn sense. Okay, that's pretty cool. I'm just gonna mess with the hair and the beard because I'm impatient to get started. So let's do that. Face. Style. Let's see what we got here. Beatnik. Garage Band. I don't wanna. Sorry about that, folks. Had a phone call. Okay. Pompadour. Nope, not my style. Casual kept. Bedraggled. Peggy Shea. Suave. A rebel. 9 to 5. Dapper. Professor. Urban Ranger. Trailblazer. Firebrand. Looking sleazy. The creeper. Come over. I'm thinking of doing the creeper. Ooh, let's see.
Color in your hair.
And get that, no, we don't want that, we want a beard. Now, of course, somebody who has... facial hair. Okay, there we go, seems to be the bushier the beard. That's Dave, survivalist. There we go.
What do you think?
That's what we'd like to see.
Beard or no beard?
There we go. And body. You know what? I'm going to make him fat. Got muscles. Skinny man. Fat man of the waists. Everybody can be jealous at how much I'm able to maintain my mass. Because I eat well. That's the story I'm going with it. And I bet a ton of people probably play large characters just because they can. Okay. Extras. Ooh, damage. You know what? Let's see how damaged we could make him. Lip gouges. Right brow deep. Center burn. Right burn. Brow gash. Middle deep. Wow, he's looking pretty haggard there. Holy crap. Whoosh. Whoosh. Can't see half of him because he's got a beard. So, let's go ahead and turn these off. Okay, all off. I thought I turned off the music. Why is it playing? It sucks. I might have to mess the sound up here. It says I have some forward bloomers. I don't see none. Oh, this is red. Yeah. Well, Enough screwing around with that. Let's do this. Yeah, I look terrible.
Hun.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay. Laundry room. Bedroom. Ooh, baby. We have a baby? I guess that's supposed to be indeterminate baby one. It says Sean, so I'm assuming it's a boy.
Wonder what Sean will grow up to be.
Yes, I wonder.
Huh. How'd you get on the floor, Mr. Bear?
Mr. Bear, what you doing there?
One day he's gonna learn how to drive.
Yep.
He'll either be great at spelling or great at smashing blocks together.
Another tricycle.
Can't wait to teach him to ride this.
You're thinking pretty ahead. He can't even crawl yet.
The glove's a little big right now, but Sean will grow into it. Should get this signed next time we're at the park.
And some of these are pretty inappropriate for a child that age. I mean, pretty early. They're going to be just taking up room for a while there. And you bought him a board game. Yeah. Weird. Well, let's go.
Ah,
Codsworth. Codsworth. Why, thank you, Codsworth. But better yet, a comic book.
Barbarian in the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite.
Newspaper.
Hmm. More of the same.
Bleh.
Hey, Codsworth.
Enjoy your coffee, sir.
Coffee cup. Yeah, coffee. Let's go. No music.
Huh?
We should take Codsworth to be service soon, don't you think?
Okay, let's go. It's almost Halloween.
Codsworth. Sugar bombs. 100% daily value of sugar.
Yeah.
Looks like the milk got delivered.
Yay, milk.
Can you get that? It's probably that salesman. He comes from your freaking...
Freaking salesman.
I'm so proud of her.
Ah, my wife's got a law degree.
Good old USA.
Ah, door-to-door salesman. Vault-tec, huh?
Go on.
Go on.
Nice to find you, sir. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Well, I'm here right now.
I'm here now.
So you are. So you are.
Hey, you just repeated yourself
now,
there.
I know. Family service to our country. You have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Wow, how, convenient. Yay! I don't even have to pay for nothing. I wonder if you should get my family. Yeah, that's right. Okay.
We don't want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. It won't take but a moment.
Let's do some sarcasm.
Now I can't wait for the world to end.
That's the spirit. Now,
Let's see.
Okay, name. What should... Mr. Hygiene. I'm Mr. Hygiene. Okay, now I'm heavy and I look like a creeper. I'm gonna be... I'm not gonna have much charisma. Go with some strength. Perception. Lots of endurance. I think I'll be a... hit people really hard. Agility and luck, and we'll leave the charisma, the thinking, and the looking pretty to other people. Let's go, Mr. Hygiene.
That's everything. Just walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Preparation is the key to survival.
Hey, peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
I've got the beard for it.
No price is too high.
Good answer.
Yeah. Apparently I'm smarter than I said I was.
Sir, Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection to be so good at.
You heard Codsworth. Go on.
One dose of paternal affection coming up. Oh, hey buddy. Little baby.
How are the two most important men?
Let's use the mobile.
Hey, how's my little guy?
She closed the door for some strange reason.
Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah, let's see. I probably shouldn't be sarcastic when I put whatnot.
Like that night in the park a year ago?
I'm not sure why that was sarcastic.
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Let's see.
Followed by... yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes.
Oh, that's the...
explosion.
That's the guy! Oh!
I'm trying to get confirmation.
That's the guy's voice. The dude from Hellboy. Oh, I'm blanking out. I'll probably remember it after this,
confirmed reports.
In about an hour. That's how it always comes to me. Oh shit.
Oh my god.
I guess we just got to the vault stuff just in time. Are you coming, woman? Where? Come on. Oh shit. Bad stuff's happening. Bad stuff's happening. Oof. I'm a participant. Let me through. Let me through. Yeah. Jesus, leave the fucking bag, man. It's the end of the world. Where's my wife? Oh, there she is. Holy shit. Don't. Nope. To yourselves, people. If nukes are coming, don't stick around for,
excuse me.
Don't stick around for your luggage.
We need to get in. We're on the list.
We're on the list. Let us in.
Adult male. Adult female.
Hurry up.
Okay, go ahead.
Oh, come on. Haha. I'm in here and you guys aren't.
Everything we can. Now keep moving.
5 minutes to doomsday. And I got in the vault. Sounds like a good deal. Oof. Oof. Come on, wife.
Almost there. We're gonna be okay.
We're coming with us.
Both of you.
We love you too.
Holy shit! Elevator down. Elevator down. Crap. Overpressure. Oof. Just in time. Just in time. I hope these loading screens get better. That's so terrible that it's just black. with that little green thing in the bottom right-hand corner. At least it wasn't long of a load. Okay, whew.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Yes, we are.
Hon? Everyone please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
We made it.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get
everyone
situated in your new home.
Our new home.
Vault 111. A better future.
Who the hell struggles with luggage?
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. We left a minute later.
No.
We don't.
Hey. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
Up the stairs.
Just head up the stairs. We'll take care of everything.
What? Take care of everything, huh? Yeah. This one's good. What the fuck does that mean? What the fuck's that supposed to mean? Mr. Rubble.
Thanks. What now?
Just follow the doctor. He'll show you where to go.
Hey, Doc.
Follow me.
I'm waiting.
This is our new home.
Yeah.
Oh, you're gonna love it. This is one of our most advanced facilities. None of the others aren't great, mind you.
Our home. Everything we have.
So, how long do you think we'll be down here?
We'll be going over all that orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
This is weird. I don't remember these in the other Fallout games.
Excuse me.
Follow me.
Excuse me.
Step in here and put your vault seat on. Just follow me.
I don't have much choice, but this is kind of creeping me out.
Be okay. Daddy's right here. See? Honey.
Are they gonna...
Could you help me?
Gonna freeze me? Oh shit, I should have helped my wife. Wait, I need to help my wife. She asked for help? Damn it. Okay, well. I mean, look at all the condensation and smoke and shit that we were seeing coming from these. It's like it's cold. They're gonna freeze my ass.
Occupant vitals. Procedure complete.
Okay.
In.
Ha! Ha! I knew it!
Three,
I knew it.
Two,
well, interesting. I mean, almost all the other Fallouts, you're playing somebody who was born well after the bombs dropped. Here you're playing somebody who was alive before the bombs dropped. That should be interesting. Other people, other than that, it's... Oh, manual override initiated. Are we back out? That works. Let me out. Let me out. Anything named Mysterious Figures, probably not a good sign. I don't think they're gonna let me out. And there's Nora. Oh, you son of a bitch. You better put that down, or I'll come right... Well, I guess I can't. Oh. Mother? I have a feeling I'm gonna find you and kill you later. You're dead, man. Dead. And back to sleep. Who knows how much time's passed? Jeez. I mean, most Fallout games happen, 180, 200 years after the, after the bombs. Nora! Nora Hygiene! Are you okay? Okay. Sons of bitches killed my wife. Nora! Nora!
Come on! There has to be a release! Come on, come on, come on! Oh, God!
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
Yeah, I'm gonna put my fist through his face.
Why would vault-tec do this?
I guess you can't get in anybody else's vault thing. Let's open this door. What's in here? Open these guys?
Can't be the only one left.
Hello? Anyone?
Nope. All these people seem to be dead. Persistence didn't help. Ooh, new jumpsuit. Clipboards. Nothing really useful. Wait a minute, what was that? Oh, it's a coffee cup. But there was a computer over here. Let's see what it has to say. Oh, oops. Okay, cryogenic. Off. Offline. Premature termination resulting in system failure. Isolated manual and remote overrides detected. Control disabled. Controls disabled. Whoa, somebody purposely did that then. Holy crap. Oh, premature termination. Okay, it's basically the same thing, but with life support. Pod occupants. Let's see. Deceased. Yeah. Okay, I'm pretty sure it's probably going to say the same for all three, so... All people, so... Let's just, move along here.
Malfunction in emergency exit door override. Please contact your vault-tec maintenance representative.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they're dead. Okay. Oh shit, red roaches. Oof. Ooh, cigarette. I could use a cigarette. Keep in mind, people, in this, these games, cartons of cigarettes are like gold. Okay, Vault 111 security instructions. Confidential, confidential, confidential. Security eyes only. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. Security staff are responsible for maintaining installation integrity, monitoring science staff activity. Under no circumstances are staff allowed to deviate from assigned duties. Insubordination or interference with vault operations are capital offenses. Security staff are authorized to use lethal force. Wow. Not nice. Protocol. Residence admittance. Upon activation, notice from vault-tec. All personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with admittance of vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the vault. Research staff will be responsible for resident intake and escort each of the designated cryogenic pods. Residents not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcibly by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into their observation chambers, dispose of any detained... Well, that's pretty brutal. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. Okay. Staff duties. Science staff. Members of the research team must daily monitor the vital signs of cryogenically preserved residents. Cardiopulmonary and cognitive activity, in particular, must be recorded hourly. Life-saving intervention is only permitted if greater than 80%... Wow. 80% of the resident population has perished while in cryogenic suspension and must not interrupt suspension. Independent research is encouraged and left to overseer discretion. Okay. That's pretty vicious. 80% of the people have to die before they open stuff up. Let's see. security. Due to the nature of the Vault 111, personnel will be expected to perform duties outside of their normal qualifications, such as janitorial duties and food preparation. The exact distribution of these rules is left to overseer discretion. Good for you. All clear and evacuation. All clear message. Following a nuclear event, vault-tec will monitor hazards such as radiation levels, enemy invasion, subsequent attacks, and other factors. Once conditions are deemed safe, this terminal will receive an all-clear notice. Upon receiving the all-clear notice, vault-tec personnel may be evacuated at overseer discretion. Disregard any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with vault-tec, including government and military. Oh, so it's all corporate. Rotco corporate specifically. Residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault-tec will attend to their needs remotely once Vault 111 staff has been evacuated. Okay. Mandatory shelter period. What's in this? Vault 111 is classified as a short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance of the vault while awaiting the all-clear signal to evacuate. In the absence of an all-clear message from Vault-tec, the overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory shelter period of 180 days of containment. Under no circumstances may Vault 111 staff evacuate during the shelter period, unless receiving the all-clear message from Vault-tec. Interesting. Oh, security logs. Let's see, October 23rd. God, it finally happened! The world's over! Barely got all the residents inside, not everybody made it. That sounded awkward. It probably sounds like crap on my recording. Oh well. Now it's just us and the icebergs. I don't get it. Eggheads tried to explain to me that keeping them frozen is a big experiment for a better future or something. I don't know. It just doesn't seem right that we were smiling at them all that time before putting them on ice. Shouldn't we have told them something? Papa? Why? Why'd we put them on ice, Papa? Okay. Christmas Underground got together with the rest of the security boys and sports staff and had a little party. Best gift that got handed out was a fancy lad snack cake. Snack of cakes. That ain't too stale. None of the scientists came. Overseer wasn't there either. I just don't get them. They hiding something from us? Another company secret only for the higher-ups. Whatever. Just a few more months until the all-clear is supposed to come through. Then we can start rebuilding. Good for you. Only a few weeks left in our mandatory shelter period. Everyone... I don't know why I keep going girlier and girlier, but... Let's try it deeper.
Only a few weeks left in the mandatory shelter period. Everyone's getting so crazy. Some people even saying the all-clear signal is never coming. We can't stay here much longer. That's for sure. It's not just the fact that I've been staring at the same rig room and bunk bed for about 6 months. It's the fact that we only have enough food left for another few months. Tops. The officer keeps telling everybody to be patient. Focus on work. He's definitely keeping us out of the loop. Something bad is going on. I just know it. The main door access to the vault exit is malfunctioning. Now the only way out is through the overseer's evacuation tunnel. How convenient for him. He was one of the science team watching the door into his office at all times from his little makeshift checkpoint. Got invited to a meeting tonight. Support staff is in security only. Sounds like I'm not the only one with an axe to grind. No all clear from Vault-tec is coming. We need to leave. We're all but out of food. I almost murdered Stanley for dropping a damn salt cracker on the floor. A handful of us confronted the overseer about opening up the vault. I never knew a man that small that could shout that loud. Now he's locked himself in his office, along with the rest of the science staff. We're supposed to hand over any food, weapons, and medicine we have by tonight, or there's going to be consequences. I've talked to everybody. It's time. One way or another, we're getting out of this vault.
There we go. Interesting. Okay. Did I see a cigarette somewhere? Oh, yeah. Gold. Get some of that tobacco gold. Okay. Oh, rust it out. I got a book. Man, he came out of nowhere.
Roaches?
Some water. There we go, I'm back up to health. Giant fucking roaches? What the hell, indeed? Cigar box. Recreation terminal, interesting. So what do they do to pass the time? What was your memo? Remember, use of the recreational terminal is a privilege. If work performance declines, this privilege may be revoked. Enjoy responsibly. Wow. Is that a video game? Like a high score thing? Let's give it a shot. The Red Menace. Okay. Okay. Looks like Donkey Kong. It is Donkey Kong. Donkey Kong. Speaking of Donkey Kong, just saw that Pixels movie the other day. Boy, was it terrible. Ah, shit! Yeah. And, you know what? I ain't got time for this. However, I will take that with me. Yeah, I can sell it or whatever, something. Okay. Dead rad roach. Probably more around here somewhere. Rad roach! Yeah! Rad roach! Like a...
Where is everyone?
Well, I think you're looking at him. Only one skeleton, so... I must... Red Roach! Red Roach! He's looking at you, bug. That was really dumb.
Is this all that's left?
I think so. Impacts... nothing here. Here. Spritz. Ammo. Don't have a gun yet. Ooh. Impacts and bobby pins. Ah, there's a gun. Awesome.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
Ah, custom weapon. Cool. Pure money. A bobby pin? Awesome. Bobby pins are always useful. Oh, it works like the last game. Yeah. Overseer instructions. Let's see what they say. Confidential. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. Your staff will be on short-term assignment to monitor basic cardiopulmonary and cognitive functions. Long-term monitoring will be handled remotely by vault-tec technicians. Under no circumstances is suspension to be disrupted. This includes the administration of life-saving measures, because we're assholes. Your staff is also considered expendable, because we're assholes. Insubordination attempts to vacuum prematurely are capital violations, because we're assholes. Unused cryogenic pods are the preferred method for cadaver disposal, because we're assholes. Okay, the cryolator, that's that one gun. I've long dreamed of making cryogenic freezing available to on a portable, on-demand foam. Cryolator is my latest attempt. Thankfully, we're in no short supply of the chemicals and components I need to tinker with the prototype. It's a nice way to occupy the time as we wait for the all-clear signal. Okay. Operations Protocol Manacle. Okay, we've already seen this. Make sure. Yeah, we've seen these before. I'm not going to bother reading them again. Ooh, the Overseer's Log. Now, how should I read the Overseer's Log? You see, he was a small guy, so how about this? The final staff orientation. Dang it. The final staff orientation is complete. All but a few of the residents down in Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled, and several from Concord as well.
Vault-tec supervisors came up this week to do a technical review with me. This vault is ready to open. I can only imagine what wonders our residents will get to witness. The notion of leaping forward in time, I almost wish I could join them and see the promise of our future realized.
The voices probably all sound terrible, but whatever.
It's happened. We were lucky that most of the staff were nearby when the early warning came through. We had less notice than expected, but only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. Resident admittance went smoothly. Everyone made it, even the family that waited until the last minute. I was worried there would be more suspicion, but things happened so fast for these people. They must have been too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods.
Systems malfunction.
Strange issue today with pod C3. Subject appeared to be having heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening, but unusual. Rita realized almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault-tec's remote override system may have sent an errant signal. We'll have to keep an eye out. I only hope their systems are reliable once we evacuate the staff. Well, apparently they're not. Supplies running low. There's been no all-clear signal yet, even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter period. Damn it.
Run hit and tab. Enter.
Supplies were never intended to last much more than that, and despite my best efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing down here. If people think we can just leave, then the 180 days up, when the 180 days up, they're insane. Radioactive exposure would still be potent enough to fry everyone if the vault seals are breached that early. The whole point of the all-clear was to receive additional instructions from main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. Can't expect our supplies to last forever. I just have to keep everything under control until the all-clear.
Oh, you failed. Mutiny.
A faction led by the security personnel have turned on me, demanding they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. I will not open the door to be ready to death out there. I'm consolidating the remaining supplies, putting the staff on lockdown. We're going to have to stop prioritizing who deserves what little food we have left, because I'm an asshole. I've been too damn generous with the air rations. If people don't like it, well, that's fewer mouths to feed.
Wow, you are. Well, Vault-tec puts middle management in charge of vaults, people who cling on to their last instructions unto death.
Terminal's got this locked.
Oh, yeah. Terminal's got this locked. Let's unlock it. That was the last thing, wasn't it? There it is. Open the terminal. Open the tunnel. Okay. Gotcha, sucker. Reload that. Oh, shit. AD cycle. A. Torso. Torso. Let's do this. Boom! 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 One last one. Where's that last shot? Well, I shot anyways, but you know what? I'm strong. I'm a big, strong man, so let's go ahead and switch over to what? I can't. Oh, there it is. There it is. Doesn't let me switch for a minute there. Sucka. I like hitting things with blunt objects. Don't waste ammo. Gotcha, sucker. Oh, shit. Gotcha. Okay. Obvious to leave.
Is anyone alive?
Oh, they opened it up.
Did anyone get out?
Ooh, ammo. More ammo. Down here. Does not appear to be so. Okay. Let's open this bad boy up. Oh, how convenient. A Pip-Boy. Hey, I hope you're that doctor that friggin' put me in the, friggin' cryo tube, bastard. Got what you deserve. That shit's dusty.
Kilobytes of RAM? Holy crap. And their nuclear technology shot through the roof, but their computer technology blew ass. So, interesting. Select a tab with mouse. Change set of selections with AD. Okay. Tab to exit the Pip-Boy. Wedding ring. Okay, let's tab out. Do this. Hit that button. Okay. Hallelujah! Shit, that's bright. So bright. Because they shine light right in your face, that's why. Jeez, man. Escaping. Let's find our son and get some revenge. Oh, hey, finally get some, finally. There's a response for Vault 111. I had no idea they would be tragically closed. In fact, this very vault was a secret experiment. That's right. I should probably talk better into the Vault 111. Every issue of The Unstoppables you collect adds a rank in the Unstoppable perk, which grants a slight increase in the chance that an enemy attack will do more damage. Let's collect the comic books. Oops, well, kind of did in the first one, too. Free at last! Look at that. There's home. Thanks for watching episode 1 of my series on Fallout 4, Down in Fallout 4 in Boston. I hope you tune in for more later. I'll try to have a video out every day. Thanks for watching. Have a great life.